Good morning. Today I want to discuss about the K-max, that is another kernel fact. So why we are going through the K-max? We have done the Boolean expression by using the Boolean source. We have reduced it to minimum number of terms. But using only minimum simple expression, you can easily reduce it to minimum number of terms. But if the expression is very complex, so by using this Boolean source or Boolean theorems, it is difficult to reduce into minimum number of terms and it consumes more time. So to avoid that problem, we are going to the K-max, that is nothing but the kernel of K. Here in this K-max, the expression, when the expression is in the complex, having more number of midterms or max terms, to reduce into minimum number of midterms or max terms, we are referring this K-max. This K-max is divided into various types. This will have the 2-variable K-map, 3-variable K-map, 4-variable K-map, and also 5-variable K-map. So, how this mapping has been done, today we will discuss. So, consider an example of a 2-variable K-map. So, in this K-map, 2-variable K-map, this is the mapping what we have to do. So, in this mapping consists of a boxes. The boxes, each box consists of a number of will give a name as a cells. So this cells will depend upon number of variables, that is 2^n. Suppose it is a 2-variable K-map, the number of cells or the boxes you have to keep as a 4, because it is 2^n number, 2^n, as it is 2^2, that is it will require 4 boxes. So for this one 2-variable K-map, I am mapping with the 4 boxes. So in this box you will have only 2 variables. The variables can be anything. It can be a form of an ABCD or it can be XYZ. So you can use any of the variables. So here for the 2 variable K-map, I am using the 2 variables as A and B. Okay. So these 2 variables are being mapped to the row wise as well as the column wise. So one variable to the row wise and one variable to the column wise. So to this one, each box you have to make an index. So here, for when A is equal to 0 row and when A is equal to 1 row, this is coming to the B. When B is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. So this is how you need to give the mapping. Okay, so here when A is equal to 1 row and B is equal to 0, this is the box contains, means this is 0. The decimal numbers here, as I am having the 2 variables, you will have, the mapping will be,
that is A, B, and
when a is equal to 0 and b is equal and a is equal to 1. So this is a is equal to 0 throw and a is equal to 1 throw. Coming to this one column wise, as I am taking the two variables, you have to represent in the form of 00, 01, 11 and 10. So if you see this one, we are undertaking the gray code sequence. As you know, binary, all the codes, binary code, gray code. So in this one, the sequence I am using is a gray code sequence. So in this, because not only gray code sequence, so one cell to the other cell, what we are doing, only one bit difference should be there. So that's why I am using this kind of sequence. Instead of taking the sequence as 00, 01, 10, 11, if you observe these two boxes or cells, there is a difference between, I mean, if you see this one, there is no one bit change. There is a two bit change. Okay, so that is for the reason I am going to the gray code sequence. In this gray code sequence, if you observe, if you compare these two boxes, 00 and 01, there is only one bit change in the index. If you compare 01 and 11, if you observe these two also, there is also one bit change. And 11 and 10, there is also a one bit change. So, for that, each box, each and every box, the rule is each and every box should be only a one bit change so that we can do mapping easily. So, that's why that was the reason I am taking the sequence in the order of 00, 01, 11, and 10. And this is for the three variable K map. You require 8 cells or 8 boxes. Coming to the 4 variable K map. Here, if your expression is having 4 variables, then you have to prefer this 4 variable K map. So, in this 4 variable K map, you require only number of cells, that is 2 power 4, that is nothing but 16 cells you require. So, in this 16 cells, so I am taking an example as variables as A, B, C, D. So, 4 variables I am taking. So, in this 4 variables, so for in the row wise A, B sequence you are getting, in the column wise you will get C, D sequence. So, as you have here also, in the row wise and column wise, I am using gray code sequence only. So, the index are 00, 01, 11, 10. In the column wise also, 00, 01, 11, 10. So, this is how you need to give the mapping for 4 variable. And here, each cell, here also, for each cell, you have the naming of the cells, that is 0, 1, 2, 3. For 3 variable, you will have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, this is the naming of the all the each box consists of 0, 0. If you observe, if you consider this pattern in the row wise and the column wise, this 0, 0, 0. So, 0, 0 in terms of decimal numbers means it is 0. If you are taking a 3 variable K map, this, if you consider the row wise and the column wise, so if you combine all the zeros in the decimal number, it is 0. Similarly, if you go for the another box, it is in the row wise you are having the 0 and in the column wise you are having the 0, 1. So that is another 0, 0, 1. This indicates in the decimal value as 1. Similarly, you have to check all the boxes. So according to the decimal binary numbers, I have represented with the decimal decimal symbols, that is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here also, in the 4 variable K map, you require all the naming of the all the boxes, 16 boxes. So here also you have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is all the naming of the all boxes. Here you can observe 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, here you are getting the 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So this is all the naming of the all the boxes for 4 variable K map. So if you observe, if you take the example of each cell, row wise and column wise, so you have 0, 0, 0, 0. in the row wise. If you convert into a decimal, this indicates a zero. Similarly, if you go for the one, that is 0001. Means it's nothing but in the decimal, you will get a value as 1. So like this, I have given all the naming of this, all the 16 cells or 16 boxes. So this is about your 2 variable, 3 variable, 4 variable, and you have 5 variables. So in this 5 variable, if your expression is having your 5 variables, taking your variables as A, B, C, D, and E. So, if your expression is in terms of 5 variables, if you are taking as A, B, C, D, E, so these are the 5 variables. So, you require 2 4 variable K maps. So, I am taking this map, this is one when A is equal to 0, and this is one when A variable is equal to 1. And the remaining 2 variables will be B, C, D, E. Here also, you will have to represent BC and D. So this is how the 5 variable K map represents. So by simplifying these things, like 5 variable, so this is as I am using the 5 variables, this is for when A variable has is equal to 0, this is the mapping, when A is equal to 1, and this is the mapping. And the remaining 4 variables are represented in this fashion. And here also 0, 0, 01, 11, 10. So here as the number of variables as 5, you require 2 power 5, that is nothing but your 32 cells or 32 boxes. So here you will get 16 and here you will get 16. So total you require 32 cells or 32 box for mapping. Okay. So this is about your 5 variable map. Now we consider some simple example, Boolean expression, and we'll solve. How we'll do, how mapping will be done. So I'm considering an example. First we'll go for that simple example as when you're taking only 2 variables. The expression will be
sum of product terms. So the expression is in the form of a sum.
sum of product terms. For this sum of product terms, each term we represent as a min terms. So this min term, each min term, you have to represent which min term has been there in the expression. In that particular box, you have to represent with the 1, because I am using the sum of product terms. So the expression is when here further has sum of product terms, here you will have A is equal to 1 means it represents A, and then A is equal to 0 it represents A bar. So this is how we use to represent when A is equal to 1, it represents as A, and when A is equal to 0 it represents A bar. So for this one we will have A and B. So A and B means when A is equal to A and B is equal to, I mean when A, B means this is how marking will be done. Then A, B bar. So in this A, B bar, when A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, this is how we have to make. Then A bar, B bar. So A bar, B bar represents here. When A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, it represents the A bar and B bar. So whatever the min terms that is present here over here, so here I have filled with the 1s. Then after doing this one, you have to minimize this x1. So here if you observe, you have to do a grouping of 1s or adjacent of 1s. Okay, so you have to see whether any 1s present in adjacent cell or not. If it is present, then group into 1 cell. So as if you are observing, this is 1 group and this is also 1 group. Okay, so according to this one, you have to write a term, min term over here. So if you observe this one, the common term for these two cells, the common is A. When A, so the term we are writing over here, yes, A. And if you see clockwise also, in the both the cells, the B is B bar, B, B is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. So it is different for both the cells. So I have to represent which variable is common to both the cells according to the row wise and column wise, that we have to represent. So this is one type of grouping. Then similarly, this in the vertical shape, this is also, if you observe, this is also another grouping. So if you see this one, in the row wise, A value is 0 and A value is equal to 1. So for this one, the row wise it is not column, but it is not same. But in the column wise, the B is common to both the cells. This B bar. The expression which term is common to the both the cells, that variable you have to write. Okay. So here you have to write as a B bar. So the final expression is nothing but A plus B bar. So this is our final expression you need to write. Okay, so thank you. So this is one of the examples.